Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData project at Easter Seals Crossroads. And today we're going to be taking a look at using dictation with a screen reader. So let's go ahead and take a look.
Hi, this is Jim Rinehart. I'm an Assistive Technology Specialist here at Easter Seals Crossroads. And today's tech tip is going to be about using the dictate tool that's built into Microsoft Office 365 in combination with a screen reader. I've had quite a number of customers over the years that have asked me, can I dictate like a Word document or an email if I'm a screen reader user? And the short answer is yes, you can get your thoughts on the page. I do usually advise people to go back and use their keystrokes though to clean up and edit as they go along, because a lot of the navigation tools don't work very well with dictate. However, most of the people that I've introduced this to find that the benefits of being able to dictate their thoughts onto the page far outweighs any of the inconveniences of having to go back with keystrokes to clean it up. So here's how it works. I have turned on JAWS 2023 and I have a Word document open up, and the cursor's in the upper left-hand corner at the beginning. So to turn on the dictation tool, the keystroke is Alt-H and then D.
Upper ribbon, D, dictation toolbar on screen, press F6 to navigate, leaving menus, leaving ribbons, edit.
Okay, so once JAWS gets done announcing what's going on with the toolbars and stuff that open up, I start dictating, period. Part of the reason for that is when you launch the dictation tool, in the toolbar, there is a button for the microphone that is automatically turned on, period. So you're going to want to certainly be ready to talk, or you're going to want to navigate in a way in order to stop the dictation, whether that's pausing or closing altogether, period, new paragraph. You're also noticing at this point that I am speaking in all of the punctuation, period. New paragraph. So, comma, to navigate to the dictation toolbar, you press the F6 key.
F6, dictation toolbar, close dictation button. To activate, press spacebar, C.
Now, that navigates to the dictation toolbar. It pauses the dictation and puts the focus on the close dictation button. If I was going to exit dictation at this point, I would simply press the spacebar on this close button, and that would exit me completely from dictate. But if I want to go back and do some more dictation, I would use my right or left arrow.
Start dictation button. To activate, press spacebar.
To the start dictation button, and then press the spacebar.
Space. Stop dictation button. To activate, press spacebar. D.
Now I'm back dictating once again. Period. New paragraph. A couple of suggestions with this is when you are dictating, to be using either a headset microphone or a decent quality tabletop microphone, period. In either case, the quality of your dictation, especially as far as accuracy, will be enhanced with these microphones, period. New paragraph. So now I'm going to go back to the dictate toolbar and pause the reading.
F6, status bar, word count 110 words, word count 174 words.
Okay, that closed the bar for me for the dictate toolbar, and it's brought me back I'm going to now task switch back to my Word document.
JAWS Professional, Document 1-Compatibility Mode-Word, Edit.
Now I'm back into my Word document as the focus, and I'm able to do all my normal keystrokes that I would do if I was running JAWS.
Top of file. Okay, so once JAWS gets done announcing what's going on with the toolbars and stuff that open up, I've...
And that moved the cursor to the top of the file with the control home key and read the first line. And if I want to select a few words, control shift right arrow.
Okay, so one, JAWS, selected.
Okay, so just like it is if you're a screen reader user, whenever you are selecting text. So now to get to the wrapping this up, the going back to the dictate toolbar.
F6, dictation toolbar, start dictation button. To activate, press space bar.
And then I can right arrow to
close dictation button. To activate, press space bar.
And I can press space bar.
Document 1-compatibility mode.
And that closes it and puts me back into my Word document. Okay, that's pretty much it. It's for quick and dirty kind of dictating, but it's a great way for folks who are screen reader users to be able to save themselves a little bit of typing. I hope you find this helpful. Give it a try, see how you do with it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.
Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.